South Africa coach Dawie Theron, a couple of days out from this JWC final. How's the South African side shaping up?
Well, I think the guys work very hard to get into this final. I mean, it's like almost a third final for us in this tournament. You know, the first one against New Zealand, we approached as a final. We know how massively important that game was. And then we had to play them again in the semis. So I think the guys are very battle-hardened. I believe the players can handle the pressure, and that's what we have to believe at this moment. If you look at the path that they had to go through to get to this final, so I believe the team is in a good space and they very relaxed at the moment. And for the first time, we actually haven't had a massive lot of injury concerns, so we can pick a strong squad. And now it's the work has been done. You know, the guys just got to go out there and enjoy themselves and savor this moment to being in the final and just give it all.
That's, I mean, they have, as you said, they've played the host New Zealand twice, and that second one in the semi-final, it was some match.
Yeah, I mean, that was a proper test match. It could have gone anyway, either way. You know, I think the guys really, really work very hard for that. And I lift my hat to them, the way that they keep on fighting in that match, never give up, always coming back with more physicality and more purpose. And somebody asked me earlier, you know, if I can pick out five or six guys that has really came through as stars in this tournament. I don't want to do that. There's only one guy that I got to mention, and that's Andre Pollard. The way his captaincy, you know, lead this team, and the way he took that, the plans and the things that we wanted to do onto the field, and the way he executed it, you just make it easy for a coach. And, you know, we actually became like we like to try to do every time we get together as a junior team, is to be a family and to make it a happy environment for the guys. And with Andre as well, we know each other now for 3 years. It's our third Junior World Cup together. So I believe that we managed to do that. So a happy team, happy environment, and I believe they are ready for the final.
And you talk there about Andre. I mean, he's been nominated as one of the four for the IB Junior Player of the Year. As you said, you know him so well. I mean, what is it that makes him stand out at this age group?
Well, I think his maturity, you know. I think Andre never gets too overexcited about things. He knows the game very, very well. I think he's a big student of the game as well. And I think he's got a good rugby philosophies, you know, that he always carry over to the players and so on, and he leads in a very mature, quiet way. You know, he's not a big shouter and stuff, and he always seems to make the right decisions. You know, so I think his maturity is one of the things that stands out for him.
That's it. I mean, it does seem that the others look up to him and literally do take their lead from him.
Oh well, I think ever since we picked him as the captain, you know, the moment he walked into the side, it was just tremendous to see that the way, although he haven't been with us that long in preparing, he just slot in immediately, because we're still playing more or less the same that we've done over the last 2 or 3 years. And so he knew the plan. And he just took control, and he just executed, you know. So I think that was also one of the things where he, at that moment, he actually draw the line in the sand for the other guys to show that, listen, I'm the guy that's in control here. And they all look up to him and admire him for that, you know, that he can just come in with that ease and just do the right things at the right time.
And it looks like the Springboks may have a number 10 in the making.
Yeah, well, it's not for me to say. I mean, the senior Springbok coaching side has got their plans, and they work very hard. And I know that they are also very fond of Andre. And South Africa is blessed with a tremendous lot of talented players. And I believe that if he works hard and stay on his game, that his opportunity will come.
And how does this class of 24 compared to the size that you had in 2012 when you won the title, you had last year when you finished third?
Well, I think, you know, one of the focuses that we've got is to get big rugby players with a good skill base through the system. And we're starting, I believe, to manage to do that. And we just got to keep on working very hard on doing it. I think in 2012, we also had a very big pack. You know, if you take a guy like Paul Willems, Rowan Botha, Pieter Steph de Toey in the pack, and those guys, if you take them into account, Ron Kitsoff, who's playing for the Stormers. So it's not, everybody say this is a tremendous big squad. Yes, they are big, but we in the past also had big players, you know. The one thing about this squad is that they are really, really very happy to be together. I mean, to be away from home for so long and in New Zealand is really a tough journey for them. And the way they handle it and the way they're working to be dominant is just tremendous. And it's a very good group of players together. And it also showed that they... It's not just the size, it's also the skill and the commitment and the drive that is in each of these players.
And how, I mean, you have experience at this tournament. I mean, how do you think the standard has improved from when you first got involved? What is it that's special about this Junior World Championship?
Well, I think over the last 4 years, it just grew into something that is really, you know, every year it seems to get bigger around the world. You can just see it in the feedback that you get and in the press and so forth. And it's proper test matches being played, you know, especially if you take games between England, Australia, South Africa, New Zealand, and if you take France and even Ireland and those guys all into account, it's proper test matches, and you know, and it's a very tough situation to play it in a 3-day turnaround and then in a 4-day turnaround. So it's becoming a tremendous occasion for these guys. It's a tough occasion, and if you look at the size and the conditioning of these youngsters coming through, and they're just getting bigger and fitter and more skillful, you know, this must be one of the toughest tournaments in the world.
And if we bring it back to the final of 2014, what are you expecting from this England side?
Well, I think we, in more ways than one, we are very similar side. You know, I think they want to really dominant up front, be dominant up front, as we like to do. Their lineouts and their set piece is very, very important for us. They scored a lot of tries from set piece. For us, that's also very important. I already spoke to the guys and said, if we can dominate up front, we've got the best chance of winning this. And so we expect them to try to do the same. I also think they've got size in the backs with speed and skill, but so we've got the same. I mean, we've got Andre Pollard, Andre Estreisen. Andre Estreisen looked like he shouldn't be playing inside center. He looked more like a flanker or maybe even in the old days he might have been a lock, you know, but he's got tremendous skill and power and pace as well, you know. So, yeah, I think it's going to be a tough, hard-fought battle and a proper test.
And how do you think it will compare facing England to facing the likes of New Zealand and Samoa as you did in the pools and in the semi-final?
Well, I think, you know, I can't see that that big a difference, you know. I think it's going to be as tough as any other of those games, you know. Luckily we've been through those tough matches, you know, and so we just got to keep on working, and we believe that we are battle hardened and that the guys will handle the pressure of this final, and that's the way we approach it. We go into this that this is the next most important match of our lives.
Okay, that's great.